Pixel 3 XL. Everybody has been asking me about the phone, asking me how it is. Is it worth the money? Is it better than the Pixel 2 XL? Is it worth the upgrade? So I'm gonna start off with you from right now. Is it worth the upgrade from the Pixel 2 XL? The answer is no. Definitely not worth it, and I'll tell you exactly why. Now, the first real thing that you have to realize is that you're getting the same software updates that you're gonna get the same software that you got on the Pixel 3 XL to your Pixel 2 XL, including the call screen, which I think is pretty awesome. The Pixel site, the night sight mode, you're getting that. Top shot, you're getting all that stuff basically baked into your Pixel 2 XL. Now, the one thing that you don't have, which is a complete difference when it comes to phone for phone, is that you do get a nice wide angle lens in the front camera, which I definitely love and definitely take advantage of. I was actually using that for Thanksgiving the other day. Definitely liked it, and it worked pretty well. I definitely liked it really a whole lot. Now, there's so many phones out there that's taking the APK and using and abusing it and just taking the features that the Pixel should just keep for itself. But that's the thing with Google. They like to have their features inside an app, and the app can be copied into an APK. Big shout out to Munchie and to Android Stud. Now, the Pixel 3 XL, tell me about it. What's great about it? Wireless charging is great. The Pixel stand is awesome. Definitely get the Pixel stand. It is on sale for $40 right now. Black Friday deals are definitely on deck, including for the whole entire device. Now, what I want to start off with is Google, you need to drop the lame colors. Not pink, black, white. You need a red phone. Need something different. You want to be professional. I understand that, but we're in a market where the iPhone is taking that title for being professional. The Samsung, they have that market too as well when it comes to Android. LG and Google are basically fighting for that second spot when it comes to Android, besides Huawei and all those companies that are not here in America. Now, the Pixel 3 XL is a great phone, but you know what else is a great phone? This beautiful panda looking color here. Now, they probably didn't drop this again because they did have some manufacturing issues with trying to make this dual tone color. So, but if you have a deep brand skin, you could try to mimic that or whatever. I'm not into skins or all that stuff. I'm more into cases. As you guys can see from my channel, I'm a case guy, so I definitely do that. But the Pixel 2 XL could do so much that the Pixel 3 XL can do, except for the wireless charging and a few other things that I probably can't remember off the top of my head. But I want to be completely honest with you guys and just tell you exactly what's cool. So as far as the speakers, I kind of feel like the speakers are a little bit muffled now. Now, I remember there was a crackling issue on my previous Pixel 2 XL that I got for a refurb that I didn't notice until later, but this one doesn't have that issue. I did have a crackling speaker issue with this one when I first got it as well, but it went away as soon as I charged the phone. But there's so many things that I want to talk about with the phone. The camera is still very, very good. So if you need a camera that could take some great still shots and some decent video, you definitely have it in here. There's people complaining about the fact that you don't have the 4K 60, 1080 60. Now, if you guys had the Pixel 2 XL, most likely on the original Pixel, you didn't get that either. So if you had the Pixel 2 XL, you already knew what to expect. But I don't think that Google is trying to aim this phone towards the people who like to change the settings. But I mean, I could be wrong with that because the camera is so good, but I think that they're trying to aim for the people that just want something simple that takes great photos, that sounds great, that feels really premium in the hand, like the Pixel 3 XL is. That's another thing I can say. It feels more premium than the Pixel 2 XL, no doubt about that. I definitely like the fact that it came with wireless charging, which is definitely a must as well. But overall, you get so much features that you get on the Pixel. So that's what I'm going to keep on saying. This is basically the S series from the Pixel 2 XL to the Pixel 3 XL. So if you guys are interested in a great, great phone, they're both great phones. They're not bad at all. They do the job. They take care of business. They're not feature packed. You do have AR stickers. You got some cool stuff. You could put the Hulk in a picture with you, the Iron Man. You can make them talk. Captain America, Those things are very, very cool. So the Pixel Buds that you get inside the box, I was wearing them at the OnePlus 6C event. Joshua Vergara said, wow, you're wearing the Pixel Buds. Like, a lot of people don't wear them. They actually sound pretty good, and the mics are pretty good as well. Like, I was doing my little vlog, and they sounded actually decent. So as far as that, and you do have the live translate with those as well, so you're not going to get that with any other headphones, especially ones that actually come in the box. So if you guys could get this at a decent deal, especially right now, there's so many deals. You get $400 off on Verizon. You could get the deal from Project 5 where you have $200 off. You could get the $200 in credit with Project 5 as well. The Google Play Store has it on sale or whatever. But as far as the Pixel 3, a lot of people like the Pixel 3 as well. But for some reason, I just like the bigger phone. Now, if you guys like the smaller phone, I have seen the Pixel 3 in person. I think it's too small. Especially coming from the Pixel 2 XL, but everything about this phone is great. But also the Pixel 2 XL is just so close of mimicking the same thing. So if you don't wirelessly charge, if you don't mind still having a little bit of bezel, then you know, just stick with your Pixel 2 XL and wait for the Pixel 4 XL, and that should be a big jump, because they've definitely learned from their mistakes with this phone. I think they need more colors. The price drop is really good right now, so if you want to hop in, you can. But if you have your Pixel 2 XL, buy a feature rich phone and go back to this phone when you want to experience the best stock that's out there. OnePlus is definitely fast when it comes to their software, but I'm definitely down with your originators, and that is Google. So before I end this video, I just wanted to talk about the notch, because I didn't want to leave that for first. The notch is pretty big. Now, as far as watching content or any type of media, you know you're going to get black bars. What happens when you get the black bars? It makes it look like you have bezels. When it makes it look like you have bezels, it probably mimics 95% that you're looking at a Pixel 2 XL. Now, as far as the display quality, totally changed night and day. I did change the Pixel 2 XL plenty of times, but the panel on here, it looks really, really nice. It makes your pictures look even better because you're putting it on a better panel and you're looking at it and you're saying, oh wow, it looks better, but it's definitely on a better panel, but it's probably the same exact software. These camera modules look exactly the same, as you guys can see, but they say it's different. Whatever. The notch. That's what I really wanted to talk about. The notch, you get two front cameras, which a lot of phones do have, but that notch is insane. I was talking about the bars. Get the bars. Big shout out to Uno Nice. He's been telling me about the notch app. I tried that. It does work, but it makes it look like I have a Pixel 2 XL. Like, I'm going to keep saying the Pixel 2 XL, because the Pixel 2 XL has to be known in this video, because a lot of people have the Pixel 2 XL and want the Pixel 3, and that's what they're going to be reminded of as soon as they have it. It feels more premium. I like the glass on glass look sandwich. It's definitely nice. The notch does get in the way at times, but it's kind of like it's there, but it's not there. Especially if you have a phone like the V40 or the iPhone 10 or the 10S Max, whatever. It's not just bigger than that one. But you know what? It's not a big deal. Like, a lot of people look at the notch and they think it's an iPhone anyway. So if you have a notch, you basically have an iPhone in everyone else's mind who knows nothing about technology, mobile technology. So I don't really care about that. But everything else about this phone is smooth. Software is amazing. Fingerprint scanner is on point. We don't have no type of facial recognition. Google, you need to add that. You need to fix your speakers because they sound a little bit muffly. But everything else about this phone is on point. But it's just so close to the Pixel 2 XL. I can't really recommend it now. But if you get it for the price drop that they're having right now, it's definitely a great phone to have. OnePlus, you're the biggest competition that Pixel has. But honestly, we're definitely in a league of our own, because we have wireless charging. And we definitely take better pictures. See OnePlus right there? So now, after this review, now I gotta get a 6T. So big shout out to Google for actually sending this out to me. Hashtag Team Pixel are definitely in the building. Yeah, yeah. So if you guys want to pick up Pixel 3 XL, the link will be down below. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up and follow Phone Tech at Work for more videos like this. Peace and love. I'll see you guys in the next video.